Security is the cornerstone of modern organizations and a crucial part of protecting their applications, data, and reputation. It was not that difficult when their applications were hosted in on-prem data center and accessed from the corporate buildings. As enterprises moved their workload to cloud and employees started working remotely, it's a big challenge for the organizations to securely grant access to their applications. Employees need access applications via VPN. Organizations need to add security policy at multiple levels to secure their applications, like VPN policy, device policy, and application policy. These policies are managed by different teams and potentially creating overlaps, making it difficult to diagnose any application access issues. It takes months and a lot of coordination between different teams to roll out any policy update. AWS's new product, AWS Verified Access, will help you to overcome these challenges and makes your application secure. Hi, my name is Ankush Goyal, and I'm a Senior Technical Account Manager at AWS. And in today's video, I will talk about a new service, AWS Verified Access, also known as AVA. AVA helps employees access their corporate applications over the internet without requiring a VPN and helps organizations to manage policy at a single place. AVA is built using Zero Trust security principles. Zero Trust is a security model based on the principle of maintaining strict access controls and not trusting any entity by default. AVA helps organizations to improve their security posture by leveraging multiple security inputs and grants access to the applications when user and their device meet specified security requirements. It validates each access request regardless of the user, network, or location before granting the access. AVA helps organizations to manage policy at a central place instead of managing at different levels. It also integrates with AWS Web Application Firewall, also known as WAF. WAF helps customers to filter out common exploits such as SQL injection and cross-site scripting. Now, let's see this in action and see how you can create AVA in your console. In this demo, first we will see how you can control access to your corporate applications by using AWS Verified Access policies. And then we will see how you can integrate WAF with AWS Verified Access. For this demo, I have already created a Verified Access instance where I will be using IAM Identity Center as my trust provider. I have also created a Verified Access group for my HR application where I have a policy saying that any user who belongs to my HR user group and has an email address of amazon.com should be able to access this application. I have also created an endpoint for my HR application which we will use to access this application. On the IAM Identity Center side, I have created a HR group which has two users, hr_amazon_user and hr_aws_user. One of the user has email address ending with amazon.com. Other user has an email address ending with aws.com. So based on our AWS Verified Access policy, my user which has email address ending with amazon.com should be able to access the corporate application, but the other user should not be able to access the corporate application. Next, we will go to a separate browser where we will try to access this application by using our AWS Verified Access endpoint. I have opened a separate private browser where I will try to access this application by using my Verified Access endpoint. I will enter the username of the user which has amazon.com as an email address. Now see, this user is able to access the HR application because the email address for this user is amazon.com and the user belongs to the HR group which satisfies the condition we have written in our AWS Verified Access policy. Next, we will try to log in by using the other user which has aws.com as an email address. I have again opened a private browser. We'll try to access this application by using the AWS Verified Access endpoint. I will enter the username of the user which has aws.com as email address. As you see,
this user has aws.com as an email address, is not able to access this application, and we are getting 403 unauthorized error message. Next, let's see how you can integrate AWS WAF with AWS Verified Access Instance. For that, go to Verified Access Instance console and click on Integrations tab. Here you have two options. Either you can create a new web ACL, but if you have already created an ACL, then you can click on Action and Associate Web ACL. Select the web ACL you have created and click on Associate Web ACL. You can also integrate AWS WAF with AWS Verified Access Instance from AWS WAF Console. For that, go to AWS WAF Console and open the ACL you want to integrate. Open the ACL, click on Associated AWS Resources, and click on Add AWS Resources. Here, select AWS Verified Access, and then click the Verified Access Instance and click on Add. Under this web ACL, I have added a rule to block any SQL injection related queries. Next, we'll try to log into our sales application and we'll see how WAF will help us to block any SQL injection related attacks. I open a private browser where I'm trying to access my sales application by passing a parameter customer ID, and I'm trying to access all the customer IDs from the database. This should be identified as a SQL injection attack by WAF and should be blocked. You can see this request has been blocked by WAF and not even going to your IAM Identity Center for any authentication. You can find more details about this blocked request under CloudWatch logs for this WAF. For that, go to CloudWatch logs and open WAF logs and go to the log stream. You will find details like termination rule ID and rule match details. Like for in our case, it was the SQL injection and what parameters were sent in the URL. Now let's change the customer ID to a valid customer ID and see what happened. Now I'm using a valid customer ID here. So the moment I use the valid customer ID, it's getting allowed by WAF because it's not a SQL injection and it's going to my IAM Identity Center to enter my ID and password. And you will see you got the results by using the valid customer ID.
In this video, we explain the challenges customers often face when working remotely and how AWA can help by providing secure access to your applications without requiring a VPN. We covered how AWS WAF can enhance security for your applications and block any malicious request before it reaches to your application. In this demo, we saw how AWA policies can be used to control access for your corporate applications and how easy it is to integrate AWS WAF with AWA. Please check the links in the description below to learn more about AWS Verified Access. Thank you so much for watching.